The Faith I Live By, a devotional by Ellen G. White. The Uprising of Rebellion. But your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hid his face from you, that he will not hear. Isaiah 59 verse 2. Evil originated with Lucifer, who rebelled against the government of God. Before his fall, he was a covering cherub, distinguished by his excellence. God made him good and beautiful, as near as possible like himself. Nothing is more plainly taught in Scripture than that God was in no wise responsible for the entrance of sin, that there was no arbitrary withdrawal of divine grace, no deficiency in the divine government that gave occasion for the uprising of rebellion. Sin is an intruder for whose presence no reason can be given. It is mysterious, unaccountable. To excuse it is to defend it. Could excuse for it be found or cause shown for its existence, it would cease to be sin. The first sinner was one whom God had greatly exalted. He is represented under the figure of the Prince of Tyrus, flourishing in might and magnificent. Little by little, Satan came to indulge the desire for self-exaltation. Though all his glory was from God, this mighty angel came to regard it as pertaining to himself. Not content with his position, though honored above the heavenly host, he ventured to covet homage due alone to the Creator. Instead of seeking to make God supreme in the affections and allegiance of all created beings, it was his endeavor to secure their service and loyalty to himself. Is he, Satan, not the first great apostate from God? It is at Lucifer's throne that every evil work finds its starting point and obtains its support.